فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. وإن شرح ذا كتاب نخبة الفكر في مصطلح أهل الأثر. And we said that the sharh that we're going to be using is the Nuzhat al-Nadar. The Nuzhat al-Nadar written by Hafiz ibn Hajar himself. We spoke about the mutawatir last lesson. We're now going to, inshallah ta'ala, talk about al-mashhur. We're going to move on to al-mashhur. The author says, وَالثَّانِي أَلْمَشْهُورُ. Now this is going to be what? The first type of al-ahad. This is going to be the first type of al-ahad. So the author says, وَالثَّانِي. What does he mean by ثَانِي? He means ثَانِي أي مَا كَانَ مَحْصُورًا. The hadith mutawatir was that which was not restricted to an amount. It's mutawatir was what? It was large in number. Sahih, brothers? So mutawatir is a whole different scope. What you need to realize, if you ever hear the concept of sahih, da'if, and hasan, you're not talking about mutawatir. Mutawatir can't be sahih, da'if, or hasan. Does that make sense, brothers? If somebody says to you, this hadith is sahih, or this hadith is da'if, or this hadith is hasan, they're only grading what? A hadith which is ahad. Mutawatir is not graded, because it's reached a level in which a person can even need to observe. Hafiz is going to mention that later, don't worry. He's going to mention that. Are we all together? You don't research into a hadith which is mutawatir. You won't look into it. Okay? Does that make sense? But the hadith which is ahad, ahad means few in narration. That's why we have to use the word few. People say singular. If you say singular, that's gharib. Singular is what? Gharib. So what you say is few in narration. Okay? It's few. So now we're going to go into the first type of ahad. First type. The first of the type is what? Al-mashhur. Mashhur is ما كان محصورا بما فوق اثنين. It's anything that's above two. So in other words, three and more. Can we restrict it to an amount after that? Can we say three and to a limit, or do you say three onwards? The scholars, the best view is that it's two upwards. So two not is it not in there? It's three ما فوق اثنين, above two. Which is three, right? Three and upwards, but بِشَرْطِ أَلَّا يَتَحَقَّ فِيهِ الشَّرْطُ التَّوَاتُرُ. And it can't reach high where it becomes multitude narration. Okay? Does that make sense? So it's three upwards as long as it doesn't reach the level of tawatur. Okay? The reason why we don't want to restrict an amount to it is that sometimes a narration could be, it could be 10 and it's mashhur, and another narration is 10 and it could be mutawatir. Are you there, brothers? Because of other external things that are there. Are you there? That give it that power. So what's better is to say, is that the hadith which is mashhur is what's three upwards, لكن بشرط ألا يتحقق فيه شرط التواتر. Tawatur is not allowed to be in there. And inshallah ta'ala, the more you study and the more this science becomes natural for you, you will start learning that. That's what Hafiz al-Mahajir believes. That's what he says in Nusratu al-Nadar. That's what he says in his matan as well. Ibn Mandah, on the other hand, Ibn Mandah is a great imam. Ibn Mandah, he resided in what time? He resided in the same era as Muhammad Nasr al-Marwazi. Ibn Manda and Muhammad Nasr al-Marwazi were together. They were the same time, same era. Ibn Manda and those who followed him, they took the opinion that the mashhur is what? مَا رَوَاهُ أَكْثَرُ مِنْ ثَلَاثَةٍ. Is any person who narrates more than three. Khatib al-Baghdadiyu, al-Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadiyu, he said in his kitab al-Kifaya, مَا يَرْوِهِ جَمَاعَةٌ. A large amount had actually narrated it. A jama'a group narrated it. The scholars, they conditioned, rahimahumullah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow His never-ending mercy onto them, that the mashhur is as long as it does not benefit you knowledge. Knowledge here means what? Certainty. Okay? What's the thing that benefits you certainty? It's tawatur. The hadith which is mutawatir benefits you certainty. The hadith which is mashhur, it benefits you what? Assumption and speculation. As they say. So this is the only difference, they say, between the mushhur and the mutawatir. That's what some scholars are saying. Hafiz ibn Hajar then said, وَهُوَ الْمُسْتَفِيضُ عَلَىٰ رَأِيٍ. And according to an opinion, Mashhur and Mustafid are synonyms. They're the same. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Yeah? Saad, can you give the book to... Naam. The kitab. Yeah. The Mustafid is the same as what? The mashhur ala ra'iyin, according to an opinion. So they mean the same. When he says that they are the same, who is he talking about? Which people of which field? The muhaddithin. He's referring to the people of the muhaddithin. And this is the strongest opinion, that they are the same. Some of the fuqaha, the jurists, they also chose the opinion that the mashhur and the mustafid are the same. They took that. Jameel. Others have said that the mustafid is not from the istilahat al-muhaddithin. It's not. In other words, the word mustafid, muhaddithin don't even use that. What they use is mashhur. And that's wrong. That's incorrect to say that. And those who've said it haven't read the books of the scholars of hadith. لماذا؟ لأن Imam Muslim رحمه الله used this. And he is from من أئمة هذا الشأن. He's from the أئمة المحدثين, right? What did he say in his مقدمه? In his مقدمه of the kitab التمييز. He says it. And he said it in his Muqaddimah of his Sahih, and he also said it in his Kitab At-Tamiz. He said it in both books, in the introduction of his Sahih Muslim, and he also said it in what? He also said it in his Kitab At-Tamiz. He said it in both of them. He also, Al-Imam Al-Hakim Al-Naysaburi, he used the word Al-Mustafid in his Kitab Al-Ma'rifah. Are you with me, brothers? So we don't want to go too much into this issue. وَلَا نُرِيدُ أَنُ الْإِطَالَةَ فِي هَذَا الْأَمْرِ. We don't want to go too much details into this issue because this is not مِنْ مَبَاحِثِ عِلْمِ الْحَدِيثِ. As Hafiz ibn Hajar رحمه الله says in his Nuzhatul Nadar. We don't do that to say that this word means the same as this one. This is not what muhaddithin deal with. Okay? But what I do want to say is that the shuhra is two types. When you hear mashhur, the word mashhur comes from the word shuhra. Shuhra is two types. There are two types of shuhra. The one that we just spoke about is the one, is called shuhratul istilahiyyah. What is it called? Shuhratul istilahiyyah. That's the first type. What does shuhratul istilahiyyah mean? It means the technical shuhra. It's the one that we just took now in Kitab Nukhbatul-Fikr. Are we all together? It's what? Three or more narrate ma lam yablugh hadd al-tawatur. As long as he doesn't reach what? Al-tawatur. Very good. The second one is al-shuhra. The mashhur, which is what? غير الاصطلاحية. Which is not what? Which is not istilahiyya. What does this one mean? This one means the hadith which spreads between it spreads amongst the people. Al-hadithu alladhi ishtahara bayna umumin nas. It's the hadith that spreads amongst the people. Aw bayna ta'ifatin mu'ayyanatin minhum. Or it spreads amongst a particular group of people who are together either for knowledge reasons, they're together because they're dealing with the same science, okay? Like the Mufassireen, or the Muhaditheen, or the Fuqaha, or the Usuliyin, or Ahlul Lugha. All of these people are ta'ifa, they're a group of people, but they're together. The people of the language, they're together. Whatever word that they use amongst themselves is known as mashhur inda ta'ifatin mu'ayyana. It's famous amongst a group of people. Does that make sense? Does that make sense? So let's break it up again. What is it? The first one again is that hadith which is mashhur, it is famous amongst the people. This is the first type of ash-shuhratu ghayra istilahiyya. The first one is, what did I say? It's umum al-nas, the general mass. Are we together? This is called al-mashhur ghayru al-istilahi, ama ash-shuhratu ghayru al-istilahiyya. And the first one of it is that which spreads amongst the general mass. And it spreads amongst the khutaba, people who do khutbas. They do that generally, it's a lot. That's the first one. And you know the famous hadith that people use a lot. It's very famous that اعمل لدنياك كأنك تعيش أبدا. Work for your dunya like you're forever going to live. You heard that one before, huh? It's a famous hadith amongst the people. Work like you're never going to die, basically. وعمل لآخرتك. And work for your akhirah كَأَنَّكَ تَمُوتُ غَدًا, like you're going to die tomorrow. صح? This is something that's famous amongst the people. It's a very wise statement, but it's not a hadith from the kalam of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another one that's very famous amongst the people is حُبُّ الْوَطَنِ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. Loving your country is from iman. حُبُّ الْوَطَنِ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. Loving your country is from what? Iman. And this لا أصل له. There's no أصل for it. There's no narration أصل for it in any way. When we say لا أصل له, we mean there's no إسناد for it. There's not even a chain for it. Are you with me? That's the first type. That one spreads because of the khutba, who do khutba and whatnot. The second type is called hadith, which is mashhura. It's famous. بين what? بين طائفة معينة. And here we mean specifically بين المفسرين. We're going to pick طائفة معينة one by one. So we make the second one بين المفسرين, amongst the people of tafsir. Are we all together, brothers and sisters? Like for example, when it came to the ayah وَفَتَنَّاكَ فُتُونَا وَفَتَنَّاكَ فُتُونَا, you find the story, the long, lengthy narration that people bring in the statement of Allah, وَفَتَنَّاكَ فُتُونَا, when they talk about the story of Nabiullah Musa from the beginning to the end. Abu Ya'la, he brings it in his Musnad, and Nasa'i brings it in his Tafsir. And it reaches how long, brothers? It actually reaches 15 pages. Now, and this is very famous amongst the people of Tafsir. And this hadith تَفَرَّدَ بِهِ, the person who became alone with it, the person who narrated it by himself, is أَسْبَغِ ibn Zaydin. And Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in, he referred to him as Munkar al-Hadith, Yahya ibn Ma'in, and Al-Mizzi, Al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi, and Ibn Kathir, and others. So they weakened him on this. Na'am. And what is strong is that this is not a prophet's hadith, rather it's the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. And Ibn Abbas took this from Ahlul Kitab. Number three, is the hadith which is famous amongst the fuqaha, the people of fiqh. It's very famous amongst them. The people of fiqh, they write this in their books, they quote it, they reference it, they say it, they repeat it. And this is the one that people generally say, which is أَبْغَضُ الطَّلَاقِ أَبْغَضُ الْحَلَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ الطَّلَاقِ. The most, the halal thing that Allah hates the most is divorce. Are we together? Does that make sense? أَبْغَضُ الْحَلَالِ, the halal thing that's most hated to Allah is divorce. This hadith, it's weak. Are you with me? Munkar. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? In its chain, and also in its what? In its wording. How can something be halal and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates it? صح? And another one is, fuqaha use this a lot. If you kutub al-fiqh, if you read it, they always bring that. The next one is within that, the fuqaha use a lot, kullu qardin jarra manfa'a fahuwa riban. Kullu qardin, every debt that brings benefit to you is haram. It's riba. If I borrow you money, or I lend you money, if any way it brings me benefit, the money I borrowed you, any benefit comes to me from giving it to you, it's riba. The qa'ida is right. And it's from the qawa'id al-fiqhiyah. It's from a qawa'id, from the qa'ida min qawa'id al-fiqh. We take it as a qa'ida. We implemented, the fuqaha used this. But it's not a hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. It's not authentically transmitted from the Prophet. And remember, this is a benefit, brothers. كل قرض جر منفعة فهو ربا. Any money that's given, borrowed to you, if benefit comes to the person who borrowed you that money, you know, you need to know it's riba. Does that make sense? Let's say, for example, I borrow you money. The reason why I'm borrowing you money is to what? So you can give me more money. That's the only form that people know. So I give you £10, tomorrow you're going to give me £15. I'm getting a benefit here. What am I getting? I'm getting my 10 that I gave and an extra 5. That's riba. That's haram, la yajuz. Are we all together? Or I'm giving you this money, this £10, I'm borrowing you it. And in the meantime, before you bring me back that £10, you're going to let me drive your car in the meantime. That's riba. Whatever that £10 brings me, any benefit, doesn't have to only be money. It's riba. Does that make sense? كل نفع كل 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 قرض جر منفعة. Every قرض means debt, loan, that brings you any manfa'a, فهو ربا. As a qa'ida, is it right? نعم, صحيح. We take it, we implement it. As a hadith, لكنه لا يصح. As for the hadith, أبغض الحلال عند الله الطلاق. Sheikh Nasir said, if a man marries a woman, divorces her, marries another woman, divorces her, marries another woman, divorce, and he's divorced over 100 women, there's nothing wrong which he has done shara'an, and he's not hated in the eyes of Allah. Are you with me? If a woman does the same, she goes into one marriage, she doesn't like it, she leaves it, she goes to another marriage, she doesn't like it, she leaves it, she goes to another marriage, she doesn't like it, she leaves it, shara'an, there's nothing wrong she done. Are we together? So the meaning is bad, is wrong, and yeah, matan is munkar, and the sanad is also both. It has both problems. Does that make sense? Naam. So shara'an, the person doesn't, is not anything haram with it, that the person does this. So anyways, these two are what? They're two hadiths which are da'if. But that, me saying that, I was talking from the angle of a shara'i perspective. But that doesn't mean I endorse in any way, form or shape that a man marries a woman, divorces her, marries another one, divorces her, marries another one, divorces her, marries another one. لِمَا رَأَيْنَا, because of that which we saw مِنَ الْمَفَاسِدِ, the harms that we saw, the children that came from it, and then the children not having their parents around, and then this a family that's broken, only Allah knows, especially in a country like this, where the society is not going to help you. Even in Muslim countries, if the child's parents are gone, the community is the father now. The society are playing the fatherly role with you. You've got a community help. The child grows up in a good environment. Does that make sense? But now if the father slightly, let alone him divorcing the mother, even if he's a bit absent-minded, he's not even there a lot of the times, he's missing, hatta there's enemies that are going to benefit from that. Does that make sense? So when you're getting married, you need to observe where you get yourself into. And once you do get into a marriage, and you got yourself into it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought children, divorce is not an alternative. The two parties have to sit down and agree, divorce is no longer, it's not an alternative. Let's think of another plan. Let's think of where is it all going wrong. Huh? But divorce shouldn't be a plan. Number four. Al-Ahadith al-Mashhurah bayna al-Usuliyin. And wallahi, brothers, this is one thing I have to say because of the problems I saw. Again, it shows the weakness that we Muslims face as Muslims. I can't talk for anybody else. I'm speaking for the people I'm from, Muslims. Every time hardship comes, we always want to find a quick way out of it. Are we all together? Sometimes you do get depressed. Sometimes you get stressed. Sometimes you feel like things go hard. Things go complicated. Sah? Like in the rujula. If you're really a man, if you're really a real man, you take it and you stick around, you hold on to it, you don't let go. Under every pressure it hits and every pain that comes, that's not just in the issue of marriage, it's in everything in your life. It gets hard. This is what life is. Didn't you read the ayah? لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. You're going to be tested. هَذِي مِنَ الْإِبْتِلَاءِ. It's from the imtihanat. What do? You take it up. You deal with it. This is something I believe if we adopt it, not only in our marriages, but we adopt it in everything, we're going to be patient for it. بِالصَّبْرِ وَالْيَقِينِ تُنَالُ الْإِمَامَةِ فِي الدِّينِ. With patience and certainty, you will reach leadership in matters. Wallahi, you become a leader. You'll be a what? A leader. We lack that characteristics. A little bit of heat, just a little bit of heat comes our way. Ooh, what did I do to myself? Allahu Akbar, I'm going. And he runs. سَيُهْزَمُ الْجَمْعُ وَيُوَلُّونَ الدُّبُرُ. He turns back. Are you with me? This is not a good characteristic. وَمِنَ الْأَحَادِيثِ الْمَشْهُورَةِ بَيْنَ الْأُصُولِيِّينَ. From the ahadith which are very famous amongst the usuliyin is hadith Mu'ad. Usuliyin, when you go to usul al-fiqh and you study it, this is the hadith that they use on their tongue. There's a story to this hadith. Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah, he came to Jami' Islamiyah, Medina. And you know he was a professor there, right, for a time. Sheikh Albani used to be a teacher in Jami' Islamiyah, al-Madinah al-Munawwara. When Ibn Baz opened it, Ibn Baz is the one who opened Jami' Islamiyah, you know that, right? The University of Medina. He opened it with his own hand. And guess who he made it the vice who was after him? Abdul Muhsin Abbad. Do you know who was the professor of Hadith? Yeah? Sheikh Albani, rahimahullah ta'ala. This was the time when the elite were there, the elite. Imagine that. Ibn Baz as the Mudirul Jami'ah, Abdul Muhsin as the vice, Albani rahimahullah as the scholar of hadith, who teaches hadith in the faculty of hadith. You can imagine the difference it is now today. and the way it was at that time. Nujum, stars were there. Ala kulli hal, ala kulli hal, al-Shaykh Albani rahimahullah came to the jami'ah. When he came to the university, Shaykh Nasir rahimahullah saw the people who were studying hadith, studying usul al-fiqh. They were being narrated to them this hadith. Are we together? This particular hadith, which is hadith Mu'adh ibn Jabal. What's the hadith? The hadith was, it's called hadith al-Mu'adh fil qada. That's what it's called. It's hadith Mu'adh fil qada. That's what it's very well known for. But the hadith has a lengthy explanation, which is that the Prophet ﷺ, when he sent Mu'adh to Yemen, the Prophet said to him, bima tahkum, what are you going to judge the people based on? Mu'adh, how are you going to judge the people? Mu'adh said, bikitabillah, I'm going to judge the people on the book of Allah. Then the Prophet said, فَإِنْ لَمْ تَجِدْ, what about if you don't find an ayah? The Prophet, Mu'adh then said, فَبِسُنَّةِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ, I will use the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِنْ لَمْ تَجِدْ, what about if you don't find it? He said, أَجْتَهِدُ بِرَأْيِي وَلَا أَلُّ, I will use my independent reasoning and I will not shorten. I will put every effort that I have to get to the best of my opinions. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Alhamdulillahi alladhi waffaqa rasula rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Waffaqa rasula rasulillah. Praises to Allah, the one who gave the ability of comprehension to the messenger of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because Mu'adh was a messenger on behalf of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, right? What did he give him tawfiq to? إِلَى مَا يُحِبُّهُ اللَّهُ, that which Allah loves. This hadith is very famous now. Extremely famous. When Sheikh Nasir came to the jami'ah, he wrote on the board the hadith and its tariqah and the riwayat and the asanid and the turuq, everything he wrote on the board. Are you there? And it was one of the things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Sheikh Nasir with, is that whenever he saw the ghira that he had, the passion that he had for making sure the ahadiths were clean, they were authentic, what the people were taking. It's exactly how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, what the Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam. This was something he, rahimahullah, worked hard on. So he taught them this hadith is weak, don't use it. So this is again a famous hadith. And you find every one of you here knows many ahadiths that the community that you're from use generally, whether it be amatul nas, whether it be the people who give verdicts and fatwas, the hadith that they use. Okay. We're now going to move on to وَالثَّالِثُ الْعَزِيزُ. We're going to now move on to the third type of what? Third type of مَا كَانَ مَحْصُورًا, that which is restricted. Okay. We're going to move on to الْعَزِيزُ. And it's the second type of what? Of الْأَحَد. We've taken the first type of الْأَحَد was what? الْمَشْهُورُ. We're now going to move on to the second, third type of al-aziz. And al-aziz here is ma kana mahsuran bithnaini, that which is restricted to two. Are you with me? Is what's restricted to? Is restricted to two. Aziz is two in the hadith. All of the tabaqat, all of the chain is two. All of it is two. Hafiz says that. Or bihima, only two. Two narrators are narrating it. That's the choice of Hafiz ibn Hajar here. Hafiz took the opinion that the hadith, which is Aziz, is two in the tabaqah sanad, is two. That's what he took. If it increases one, it becomes three or increases, and it doesn't reach haddu tawatur, is what? Mashur. So if it becomes three, are you there? And it doesn't reach haddu tawatur, for him it's mashur. And we mentioned that before. Ibn Manda opposes Hafiz ibn Hajar in this. Even though Ibn Manda is before Ibn Hajar, Ibn Hajar is opposing Ibn Manda in this issue. And there's an opposition on these two imams. Ibn Manda rahimahullah, he is in opposition to Hafiz ibn Hajar in this issue. And the majority of those who wrote in Mustalah al-Hadith are in line with Ibn Manda, not with Ibn Hajar. Are you with me? The scholars who wrote in Mustalah al-Hadith, the scholars who wrote in Mustalah before the timing of Hafiz ibn Hajar, they all were in line of Ibn Manda. Like Al-Imam Ibn Tahir al-Maqdisi. He has a kitab called Shurut al-A'immat al-Khamsa. He has a kitab called Shurut al-A'immah. He mentions the view of Ibn Manda. Nawawi mentions the view of who? Ibn Manda. Ibn Salah, he mentions the view of Ibn Manda. Ibn Daqiq al-Eid, he mentions the view of Ibn Manda. Ibn Kathir, he mentions the view of Ibn Manda. Al-Iraqi, he mentions the view of Ibn Manda. Rahimahumullahu. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rahimallahu al-jami'. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon each and every one of them His mercy. They all saw that the hadith which is aziz is two narrated or three from the narrators. He believes three is what? He believes three is mashhur. Hafiz ibn Hajar believes is mashhur. And two is what? It has to be only two. Now, that's what he believes. So we say that the previous a'imma, they were of the opinion that it's two and three. Hafiz came, he restricted it to two, and this is an istilah which is khas of two Ibn Hajar. وَهَذَا إِصْطِلَاحٌ خَاصٌ بِهِ لَمْ يُسْبَقْ إِلَيْهِ. No one preceded him in this. This is specific to him. It's specific to Ibn Hajar. And the khilaf here comes from a concept of the word aziz, is it taken from qilla or is it taken from quwwah? We're not going to go into that too much. If you want to do more bahth of it, go look into it more in details. Then Hafiz ibn Hajar says, وَلَيْسَ شَرْطًا لِلصَّحِيحِ خِلَافًا لِمَنْ زَعَمَهُ. And Amir Sanani says, وَلَيْسَ شَرْطًا لِلصَّحِيحِ فَعْلَمِي وَقَدْ رُمِي مَنْ قَالَ بِالتَّوَهُمِ. Amir Sanani in his kitab Qasab al-Sukar, which is the nazm of Nukhbatul-Fikr, what did he say? وَلَيْسَ شَرْطًا لِلصَّحِيحِ فَعْلَمِي وَقَدْ رُمِي مَنْ قَالَ بِالتَّوَهُمِ. Some scholars, they said, or specifically Hakim, rahimahullah. Al-Imam Hakim specifically said that the condition of Al-Imam al-Bukhari for hadith to be sahih, it is that has to be aziz, at least. The minimum. He said, it's a shart lis-sahih. For hadith to be sahih, it has to be, what do you call it? Aziz.